by umpire Phil Matten.
Catch!
Well, so nearly. Tremendous effort by Maramba. Five overs bowled and only four runs and over with both openers dismissed.
Well, what a terrific start it's been for Will Leith. He's already picked up one wicket and tossed the ball up very full. And he has a dip at it. Sims, Maramba couldn't quite get up there. I've expected a little bit more emotion shown by the young man there. Just a run of the hands to the hair, Bob.
Seb Frankie Mateka coming on at the northern end. So a double bowling change for Wimbledon. 20 overs only at Swardeston disposal. They've had a quarter of them. Managed only 20 runs. Still in the mandatory power play, the first six overs in 2020 cricket. Down the leg side, and that will be wide. This time umpire Ben Debenham with the signal.
Well, bringing on seam. Surprising, really, we have to just see how much the ball is spinning on the surface. There are two other spin options in the Wimbledon side. We know in 2020 cricket, get those spinners on as early as possible. Try and starve the batsman of any pace, not giving them the option to work the ball around. Is a very rough wicket. Had a look at it this morning.
Down leg side again, and another wide.
Touch of nerves popping in, maybe trying too hard. He's looking the ball very, very straight. Just got to try and settle in on that off stump line. Bit better. One thing I've noticed this year, Bob, I've had the opportunity of playing a couple of league games, club games, and tend to find the batters at that level actually play seam medium paces quite well, but it's more the spin that they have the problem with.
Another miscue. Balls are ticking by here. Swardeston have got to do something about this. You're right, Robert, it's so much more difficult to manoeuvre slow bowling around, even if the ball isn't turning. There's always pace to work with the medium paces. It's a good yorker this time from Frank and Mataka.
Serious looking faces. They've got to try and lift the pressure that's on them. Swardeston batsman. That's down to Jaden Hatwell, Richard Sims. There's a bit of experience out there. Jaden Hatwell is 32, Richard Sims 31. So they've got plenty of experience under their belt. Three ODIs for Zimbabwe, so.
Well, was there any glove on that? But the keeper hasn't held onto it in any case. So it was runs. So is this a chance to Tom Morris?
Does it carry? Back of a length, gets the pull on, off the glove. Yeah, looks like it carries and on the roll. Just on the roll, the momentum of his arms flicking across his body, couldn't hold on to the ball. What a great six overs that would have been.
Well, that run rate steady at four runs and over, but that's not the sort of return you're looking for during the first power play. Ball seamed around early on. Ball jagging back from the in-swinging Richard Banham. For Will Leith in his very first over. And the desperate slog from wrist skies the ball to Maramba. Just 24 for the first power play.
I'm going to try and find a way of Swardeston getting back into this game. Hotter start for them, 24 for two off, six.
Carry!
Plenty of air from Leith, that's good to see. Swardeston play their cricket in the East Anglian Premier Cricket League. They finished third this season.
Down, down.
Just notice a Will Leith has kept mid on and mid off up. Swardeston have got to try and get one of those men back.
Down.
But there doesn't seem to be any of that intent, because certainly in a professional game you would know that a spinner would very rarely be allowed to bowl with mid on and mid off up. As he's, why would he be pushing it back? There's been no risk. Helping the batsman out there.
Cow!
This is very fine bowling. 17 years of age, this young man. And although they're not hitting boundaries, Swardeston have got to get this scoreboard moving. They've got to pick up some singles, rotate the strike.
Just the one.
At last, with the mid-off dropping back to long off. And there's a misfield allowing them back for two.
But I don't understand why Wimbledon pushed back long off. There hadn't been a risk taken. You want the batsman to come out of his crease. You want him to try and come down. We know the pitch is turning. You've played into Swardeston's hand there.
Oops. 26 now for two. A long road to these semi-finals of the Cockspur Club 2020. Swardeston have won nine matches to get here. The Oundle Town in the quarter-final by three wickets to take their place in this southern semi-final. Second semi-final between Bootle and South Northumberland.
Well, there's plenty of encouragement in this wicket for good bowling. We saw some, well, we saw Richard Banham at the start getting some seam movement. And now Seb Frankie Mataka is getting some seam movement as well. Will Leith is getting some spin. So if you know what you're doing, you are going to get some assistance out of this surface.
Well, that's very wild and woolly down the leg side. So another extra to Swardeston's total. They need every run they can get. Four wides and a leg by.
There are two other spin options, Steve Hobson who bowls off spin and Steve Trenchard who bowls leg spin. Surely that time is coming to see one of those come on. Yes.
The other choice that Neil Turk has is he going to bowl Will Leith straight through his quota of four overs? Two overs, one for five for the 17-year-old. Again, a decent stroke hits the fielder.
Travelling here this morning, you always get that feeling, is today going to unearth somebody? You know, and okay, we're only sort of half an hour into the day, but there's some encouraging signs.
Well, the standard of this cricket, particularly from the fielding side at the moment, is very high indeed. One or two nervous pieces of ground fielding, that's understandable. These guys aren't used to be in their coloured clothing in front of the Sky Sports HD cameras. Again, straight to the fielder. And Jaden Hatwell completely bogged down here. Eight overs gone. The run rate is just over 3.5 an over. Surely inadequate by the East Anglian team, who won the toss here and chose to bat first. Weather happily has brightened up. Hope the rain has gone away. It rather blighted 2020 finals day. The professional game. Matches interrupted, delays during the day for a very patient crowd.
Oh, down!
Well done, well done.
Extremely mature bowling this by Will Leith. You have to be impressed by this young left armer, Robert.
I am. He looks confident. Good stop again there. Attacker. Perfect bit of fielding. It's what you need as a bowler, especially a young bowler. His consistency has been impressive. Doesn't look fazed. Just gets on with it. Nice, easy action. Lands it there or thereabouts with a bit of spin.
Catch!
Down the track. This time it's a beautifully executed shot. Richard Sims getting to the pitch of that. Smashing it away over the top of extra cover.
It's badly needed from Swardeston. Richard Sims gets a little bit of width. First time he's used his feet. Terrific shot up and over extra cover. Good strike. Four runs.
Robert Croft mentioned those big boundaries. That's allowed Sims to get back for two, although he had to employ the dive.
That's what you see, Bob. They see the boundary rope and it's almost like a magnet. We have to stand on the boundary rope. You don't do that. You come in 10 yards from there. All these fielders are on the boundary rope out there. They need to be in a bit.
Easy single. Ball tucked into the leg side.
Let's look at them. They're walking back right onto the boundary rope. They don't need to be there. They need to be in 10 yards. They can always skip back. Now that just opens up the angles to push the ball in for twos and even make them into threes. They need to cut down the angles. All of them on the ropes.
Oi, on it, on it. Easy, easy.
37 for two from nine. Better over for Swardeston. Eight runs coming from that one. So the run rate ticks above four and over, but Wimbledon will be the far happier side currently. Really stuttering progress from Swardeston. Those wickets going down in the fourth and fifth over. Now, Neil Turk making a further bowling change at the northern end. And it's going to be more spin. Stephen Trenchard coming on. Some very, very talented all-round cricketers in this Wimbledon outfit. Trenchard's an opening batsman. Stephen Hobson, you heard Robert Croft telling you, is a leg spinner. He also opens the batting with Trenchard. So it's clearly... talent all the way down the list for Wimbledon. Jaden Hatwell. Just looking out on the leg side boundary, there's a deep backward square leg and a deep mid wicket. Should be plenty of opportunity to pick up two on the leg side.
Down!
Got to do something, yeah, Swardeston. They can't let Trenchard settle in and get into any sort of rhythm. They've got to jump on him. They've got to boss this situation and get some momentum going.
Oi, on it. Well
done. It's a much better delivery. It certainly allowed Trenchard that first ball loosener. Easy to pick up the grip of these bowlers on this bright pink ball.
There. Well done. Three dots, three
MCC
dots.
Hoping that the pink ball retain its colour. Well done. See later on how it looks under the lights, how the skillful cameraman can pick up the flight of the ball.
Hold.
Jaden Hatwell is using up a lot of deliveries. It's only 10 off 23. Almost getting to that point where you have to have a dip or get out. He's got to try and get to a position where he can get 120 on the board for his team.
One next.
Just a single.
They used to call that. They used to put bats in the window, didn't they, when it was time for you to get out. They never had that problem with me, Bob. See any bats in the window yet?
In the air, but it's wide of Long On, who can't stop the boundary. So at last, a much needed four for Swardeston. After 10 overs, halfway, they're 43 for two. Well, just 10 overs left for Swardeston to improve on 43 for two. They must post a three-figure score here to have any hope at all. They've got to get this run rate up, but Will Leith doing a great job from the pavilion end in the commentary box now. Rob Key and Charles Colville.
Down.
Still no run. Thank you very much, Bob. So, 17-year-old who has played a little bit of representative stuff. The lower age groups, showing that spin is not necessarily a thing which you only get right when you've got bags and bags of experience. Bowling beautifully, holding the ball back, changing his pace nicely. Wants to be a doctor. Operating pretty well at the moment. Where's that been slotted away to? Deep mid wicket, not going to be a boundary.
Great work. Yeah, he's bowled in the start off in the power plays as well. Had good courage, not just darting the ball in, as you said. Prepared to change his pace, give the ball a little bit of air. Mid on and mid off up.
Straight down the ground. That is a good shot. Not got it fully though. There was really heavy rain here this morning, driving down to the ground first thing. The M27 was like a river. It was absolutely awash. You had to basically drive at about 10 miles an hour for a while. And this outfield was really, really wet. The rain has just drained through it, but it must have just slowed up the way that the ball's running.
Yeah, it makes fielding a little bit harder as well when you're not quite sure of your footing, but the drainage in these grounds now is unbelievable. I mean, all the rain that was on the covers just got pushed off onto almost the edge of the square and it's gone, it's nowhere to be seen. But the outfield still looks pretty quick, even though it has been raining. Absolutely rapid when you haven't had a downpour like we've had this morning.
Catch!
Court and bowl chance dropped. Seemed to take Leith a little bit by surprise. Hit very fiercely. 11 overs gone. Let's have a look at it again.
Leith giving it a little bit more air. Has been smashed back and knocked him off his feet.
Leith has bowled out now. This is his wicket, tossed up. Rash shot. Not quite sure where he was trying to hit that ball. Wrist. But all he managed to do was slice it down cover's throat. So Leith has bowled out four overs, no maidens, 1 for 18. Good figures in any form of the game.
Yeah, without a doubt. And he bowled in the power play with fielding restrictions. So a young man, a lot of pressure on him. He's done a fantastic job.
Down!
Getting through their overs here with these spinners on Wimbledon. Flying the flag for the south of the country, Wimbledon. Playing the Surrey Premiership. Came second in the competition this year in the league, which was won by Reigate Priory, who were finalists in this competition last year, went out in the semi-final stages. Jason Roy played for Reigate last year, who's made quite a name for himself this season.
Yeah, he did. He's, I think,